All right, to the human face of this inquiry, Julie Lamrock is a shuttle driver who on the 19th of March drove a passenger from the Ruby Princess at Circular Quay to Campbelltown in Sydney's far western suburbs. A few days later, she started developing symptoms. Julie Lamrock joins me now from her Blue Mountains home in New South Wales. Julie, thank you very much for your time.
Hi.
Hi. Firstly, most people are yet to have first-hand experience or know someone who's suffered through COVID-19. Can you put into words exactly what it was like to have the virus?
I had no concerns that I was going to get any germs off this lady. She sat in the back. I sat in the front. Mm. By Sunday afternoon, I could hardly walk. And then Monday morning, New South Wales Health rang me at 11 o'clock in the morning saying that my passenger had been infected on the Ruby Princess and she had tested positive. I've had so many complications. My hands and feet are swollen. My nerve endings in my body are sore to touch, even wearing a bra. Hurts wearing a bra because the tightness. I have a heavy chest feeling in my chest. I get freezing cold, and 2 minutes later, I could be sweating like you wouldn't believe, perspiring unbelievably. My hair is very, very thin now.
Julie, I want to get your reaction to some of the findings you've just heard about. What are your thoughts about criticism being levelled so heavily against the New South Wales Health Department?
Ruby Princess left on the 8th of March with the health department's authority. They knew something was wrong in the first time when it first sailed. Then why weren't they cautious when it came back? Mm. It came back and ported through the night 2 days earlier when they could have been out sitting heads and they could have helivacked the patients that were sick off, sent specialists and teams and testing systems into the ship all masked up, and then reassessed the situation before they actually pulled in. The same day they had another ship to dock that was expected to dock, which was pushed and bounced back to 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Now, I have copied text messages from my passenger from her room, because I was down there early because I live so far away and I go above and beyond for my passengers, and I make sure I was down there at the quay waiting for her before she got off. So I'll be there ready in case she was off early. And I phoned her, let her know that I was in the area. And when she was ready to get off, I'll be there. All she had to do was let me know. And she said, I'm in my room. I'll grab my bag and I'll come out. And then 7 minutes later, after a few text messages, I already had a message from her saying that she was outside, off the ship, ready, but the curbside. Where am I?
Do you think you'll ever get back to shuttle driving?
I have no choice. I spent a lot of money on earn my vehicle. I have a service dog, so my companion dog's with me all the time, and I need him as much as he now needs me. He's 3 and a half, and I will have to try and find another business that I could do with him and use my van, my vehicle, that I like and enjoy. I go above and beyond for what I do.
Can I ask you this question? Would you be satisfied if those within the health department, some of those heads would roll?
People are to blame. People died. Mm. People are infected.
What do you think of the health minister? The health minister, Brad Hazzard, was very supportive of his New South Wales health team.
I've got no compensation, no money, not entitled to anything. I said someone has to be accountable. Someone has to help the people besides businesses that are failing. They had to help the sick. And I'm on a 12-month waiting list for the pain management clinic in the McMahon Hospital. I have to wait 12 months. I'm going to have this going on for a long time.
Yeah.
12 months is too long to wait.
It is too long to wait.
I need help, not just people saying in the newspapers, oh, you know, the state governments and local governments are going to have to be responsible for patronating the local cities and townships for loss of earnings for having the borders closed. Unfortunately, if we need the borders closed to save us all from getting sick, well, so be it.
Yeah. Julie, thank you very much for your time.
That's all right. My pleasure.
And all the very best too.
Thank you for listening to me.